Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am your host, Damon Pettit. And I'm going to do a nice little cigar that I've done. I might have done this one before. I'm not exactly sure, but saw it in the store and thought, kind of want to smoke that one. And trying to see if I could see the price on it. Right now, I don't know if I can, but anyway, this is going to be kind of, I guess, it's going to be a review slash just bull session, maybe, just chat for a little bit. And look at that, huh? It's pretty nice. No, I'm not seeing it on there. So, too bad. It's not going to be as much of a review as it is just to hang out, smoke a little bit, and talk about some things. You and I are going to have a conversation. It's something that like a parent would say, right? Jesse, you and I need to have a talk. No, we don't. Punch is one of those, a mass-marketed cigar, one that I have had many, many times. It's usually this one. It's a 5.5x44 ring gauge, so the ring gauge is decent size. Always been pretty decent cigar. Never had any real problems with consistency or anything. So that's why I wanted to smoke this one again. And I don't know if I've done a review on this one for sure. It's a poncho, I believe. But I have done a few reviews on a couple punches, I believe. I think. That guy got a problem. There we go. Cap kind of came off of that shit. It's right though, it should be okay, I think. Bit of really spicy. But not too. I hope everybody's doing well. Gonna have myself another coffee like I did the other time. There we go. That's all set, ready to go. There's a lot of, not a lot of, there's a bunch of shit going on, huh? Life. Life gets busy. Gets very busy. For those out there that have kids, I don't have a kid, but I have one that lives. That's my roommate's child. And so I have a deep caring for it and everything. For him. It's not really an it. So I understand how to have a small understanding how parents, what they have to deal with, and wow, pretty incredible. But anyway, what I think I want to get into is some different things like this whole FDA thing, shit that's going on, how they're regulating things, and you can go to cigaraficionado.com and see Marvin Shankin's opinion on it, and thoughts, and stuff there, and was actually kind of giving everybody an update. I'm sure a lot of you have already seen it, and this is not old news, but it's getting, you know, it's already out there. But I just wanted to throw this out as well. Cigar smoking decent. See how the construction is and stuff. I don't know. Bit of a thicker burn line going sometimes. That it's not bad though. It's not too thick. See how it keeps going, but the wrapper looks pretty nice. It's got a really deep, almost a Brazilian look to it. Brazilian tobacco. But starting to talk about, isn't there like a little, I don't know, sorry, the whole FDA thing. One thing I have a habit of doing, which I really need to get out of doing, is I've been, like when I read something, read this person's opinion, whoever it is, I'll go through some of the comments, you know. And that really is something I should not do, because comments nowadays are made by everybody. And when I say everybody, I mean a lot of people who don't put any actual thought into what they're saying or have a clue about what they're talking about. And that is always... that always is really, like, irritates me pretty bad. And it shouldn't, because I shouldn't even read it if it does irritate me. What I need to personally take a little bit of time and go through this FDA thing, because I really haven't. I know this has all been going on for quite some time. But I want to read it and everything. Now what the article, the comment, whatever you want to call it, Marvin Shankin wrote, the update, he said that they are not planning or going to regulate premium cigars. You know, you'd think, oh, that's perfect, you know, because to all of us, this is considered premium cigar. There are many, many brands of very good cigars that range from anywhere, literally from $3.50 to $100 a stick. I know that some cigar snobs will put, you know, will say, no, you know, premium cigars are $30 sticks. People like me, who would never go out and buy a $30 stick just to smoke and hang out with, to me, a premium cigar is, in my opinion, any cigar that is handmade, hand-rolled in tobacco that is aged, and not just aged, but, you know, pure tobacco, not bullshit, not machine-done tobacco, not any kind of enhanced, flavored, anything like that. So I, you know, everything that he wrote in his little article there, completely, I agree with the guy 100%. And there's really no agreeing about it. He's just, what he's doing is informing the public that they plan on not doing any kind of FDA crap. FDA doesn't plan on doing anything with premium cigars, but they are defining right now, at this moment, they are defining a premium cigar as any cigar $10 and up. So what's that going to do? That's going to destroy a lot of crap. That's, you know, it's going to drive cigar prices. It's going to really hurt a lot. So there'll be a link in the description. It'll be, it's actually going to be above the link to my website. So you can go there, and what the link is the FDA is allowing comments, allowing cigar smokers, yada yada, to give their opinion and stuff like that. So it is very strongly advised that we kind of, if this is something that we enjoy doing and we enjoy how everything is right now, as far as how cigars are priced and sold and all that crap, that we go to that link and we say, hey, you know, this is what I think a premium cigar is. You know, and putting it at a $10 price is just bullshit. But then I read down on the comments a little bit. So I'll go into that just a little bit. That, go down in the comments, and you have some jackass that says, if you cared about the American tobacco sales or whatever, you would name a Cuban cigar as a cigar of the year or something like that. So you got people that don't know what they're talking about, and then you got another person that says, I know your job is to sell, you know, cigars in your magazine and everything, but it goes on, you know, how cigars can cause cancer. I really hate to tell that individual, but the air that they breathe can cause cancer. More than likely, that person will sit back later on in the day and have themselves a soda or something like that. And that can cause cancer. The unbelievable amounts of sugar that perfectly legal and everything to sell, soda, sugar has been proven to be more addictive than cocaine. And sugar is what cancer feeds on. So if your body is lacking some fight, your cells in there can fight away and destroy these other shitty cells, then they'll end up, these cancer cells, which are in everybody, that usually will end up killing themselves, they end up flourishing in some people's bodies, and in some cases they end up killing the person. Other cases, the person fights it, does all the bullshit, and they live. But that cancer will feed on the sugar. And that's the reason why in a lot of the chemotherapy thing, and I don't know exactly how, I'm not a doctor, not a chemist, pretty much just an idiot. So, but chemotherapy, like the drip or whatever that is, has in it glucose. And so in this glucose cell, inside the cell is the chemo. And so the cancer will end up enjoying this sugar, and then they get the shock of their life. And if it happens right, then it'll kill the cancer off. But it just blows me away how a big part of it is all of our fault. we have people in office that are making laws that are bringing in people to head up things like the FDA and different things like that, that are bought. They're bought and paid for. I mean, even something like this isn't that great for you. Because it's got some shit in it. Not just coffee. And I can't fucking read it, so it doesn't matter. If you can't read it, there's nothing bad in it, right? But, you know, if people like that person so concerned about a cigar causing cancer, which I'm not going to sit there and say, oh, they don't, you know, there's no danger there. Sure there is. There's danger with everything that we have. But if that person is so concerned, then they should be talking more about things like Monsanto and stuff like that. And if you don't know what Monsanto is, because a lot of people don't, do a little bit of research on them. Find out the kind of lives that Monsanto has ruined. And if you don't like reading and doing the research, like by reading and stuff, take a look at a documentary called Food Inc., which is food and then INC, like Food Incorporated. So Food Inc. is the name of the documentary. And it might not be something that you want to watch, but just throw it in. It's on Netflix. It's on, I believe it's even on, probably on YouTube for free. You can just watch it and learn and see what our country has kind of become and what, how it's ruled, really. All in all, any kind of tobacco regulation or tax or anything else is bullshit compared to what this whole Monsanto thing is all about and what happens to the different, you know, what they're doing. Now, this is just an example. They have somehow, they were allowed to put a patent on a soy seed. And then the soy seed is genetically engineered. And anybody who tries to have their own soy and use their seed, their own seed from the soy, that's a clear, clean seed, doesn't have their Monsanto's chemical on it, Monsanto will go after them for patent infringement or something like that. I don't remember exactly. It's been a little bit, and I honestly try not to think about it too much because it infuriates me. But they have put many farmers out of business based on their patent on the soy seed. Now, what do you think what would happen if they did that with tobacco? Luckily, other countries have completely banned Monsanto and their products and stuff like that from their country. Well, while our whole entire United States of America, our government is pretty much fighting for them. And they are really destroying our food and our food chain, that whole thing. I mean, this is all doom, gloom, bullshit kind of crap, but you know, honestly, if we're going to pick a fight, I do something that's really, really worth it. I do think, for me, it matters as far as what the FDA does with their regulations and their changes that they try to impose. So I'm going to go to that link and I'm going to give them my opinion and let them know that, no, a premium cigar is not a $10 and up cigar. Premium has nothing to do with the price. So, that's my take on that. I think it's important that, you know, we unfortunately, at this moment, really should not and cannot trust what our Congress, what our senators, what all those people, we can't really trust what they are doing. They are not really working for us anymore. They are being bought and paid for by these giant businesses, oil and all that crap. So, really all I do, at least I am, doing what I can to learn about who's doing what, what's doing who, and who's screwing who. Then I end up enjoying other parts of my life when I try not to think about that other crap. I don't need to delve into it. It doesn't need to become my life. But I like to at least have my eyes open and know who's fucking me in the ass. Coffee. It's a Starbucks one. This is really pretty shitty. I had it the last time, but this time I stopped at this Pump and Go or whatever the hell it's called over here, and I didn't want to buy a soda, and a lot of the iced teas now have crap in them, so bought this, and not that great, so I just need to start planning and making my own coffee like I have before. Everybody's doing well. I'm doing pretty decent. I did not do a cigar review last week, although I did sit by the pool and relax and enjoy a cigar at night, which was really pretty nice. It's been very beautiful out here. This is the time of year where weather is still just about perfect. It's not blistering hot, but it's nice and warm. Let's see how hot it's supposed to be tomorrow, okay? Look at WeatherBug. Right now it's 87. There are no weather alerts. Wow. Wednesday, high of 77. It's actually pretty chilly for this time. It's going to be very nice. It's only going to be in the 90s this entire week. The 70s, 80s, and 90s. So, in case you're coming to Arizona, you now know the weather. Just hanging on to that ash this time, aren't I? Usually punch that baby off of there. Just letting it hang right now. Letting it have a little life. I'm trying to think if there's any badass stuff I've been doing. Nothing really. I've just been really busy. Trying to do a lot of different stuff. Trying to learn a lot of different stuff. What I'd like to do is just go someplace for like a month. That's just nobody around anywhere. And I can just sit there, stare. Stare at the sky, just veg out. Light wind, if you couldn't tell. Now I went to go knock that off and it fell off. It's burning really nice. Cigar is smoking nice. It's a kind of a medium body. It's not a strong cigar, but it's nice. It's got a decent flavor. Nothing, just like, I wouldn't be like, oh, you gotta have this cigar. But I would buy them for friends just to hang out with and, you know, go, if you want to go fishing or golf or sit and play some poker, that kind of crap. It's be a good cigar for all that. Be a good cigar for just hanging out. Sorry, my nose is itching. I'm not picking my nose in front of you. got really a real dark piece of toast. That's what my taste is right there. A little bit of if you brushed it with a little bit of just a real quick brush of mint, and then burned some toast, and had some pretty dark toast. Just a smothering of butter. Smothering is not even a word, I know, but it is now. That's what I'm getting. Different tastes here, different flavors. Flavors. Football draft is coming up, and I really don't give a shit about it. Really don't. Nowadays, it's the whole football draft just really doesn't do anything for me. I used to get really excited about it, get into the whole. Like, I would sit there and listen. This was back in the day. They didn't used to have it on. They would have, like, the first, I can't remember, the first few picks maybe on TV, you know. So it was quite a long time ago. And so I would listen to the rest of it on the radio. And I used to love that, but now it just really, it matters, but it doesn't matter that much, because a lot of times teams will get this great number one draft pick and they'll suck, or they'll get this great number one draft pick and they'll be at another team in a year or two, either because of performance or because of pay scale or because there's another better one that came around, or the sixth rounder plays better than that first rounder. Just, you know, it's just, and I know it's been that way a little bit forever, but it's like, it's more messed up now, I think. You get a lot of juniors coming out, and some, you know, are just spectacular, and they have that ability, and, you know, luckily they do well, and so not finishing their school is no big deal to them. Others, however, they need to go back. That shot right here, I got a bump in my face. The hell is it right here? It's weird, I can't even feel it. Well, I'm glad I found this little spot that's around here that I can come to, just because it's pretty quiet. I can hang out, do this. It's really close to my place. And it's pretty much low-key. I would really like to do a lot during the day, but I'm so busy. And I do other things. And this is like the best time for me to be able to relax and smoke a cigar. So I hang out with you all. Hit my foot on this bench. It's cement. Anyway, one quick thing about the NFL. I was thinking the other day, and I don't do that often, but I was thinking that, in my opinion, and this is just my opinion, which really, when it comes to football, is based on nothing, and is usually wrong. But I really think and believe, possibly, that Andrew Luck might be one of the, as far as the newest QBs out there, might be the big one. I think so. I know Kaepernick is good. Little Russell guy is not too bad. Firmly destroyed my team, gutted my team, took the guts and smeared it all over their face. That's what happens. And it wasn't necessarily him. He didn't lose the game. But he's a good quarterback. I actually like that little guy. So for those of you that are Seattle fans, I don't like your team, but I do like your quarterback. And it's not so much the Super Bowl that the reason why I don't like your team. I just never have. If any of you are however old you are, you'll remember that the Seattle Seahawks used to be in the same division as the Broncos. So we play your asses twice a year. Guys used to kick our ass in the kingdom, all the time. Loud, loud place, of course. It's no better where you are now. It's loud as hell there, too. But I remember it was just so loud. I was never there, but watching on TV, it was loud. And the whole Bosworth thing, that made it fun to hate Seattle. It really did, because Brian Bosworth had this, but he was this okay athlete, but he was a smart man. There was a time where, when he was first in the league, he was talking a bunch of crap. And talking a bunch of stuff about John Elway. Can't remember exactly. I think he was making fun of his face, kind of thing. And Denver hated him. All the fans hated him. And so, all of a sudden, all these shirts some other things were being sold in Denver about how they hate the Boz sucks, all this kind of stuff. And it was Brian Bosworth that was selling them. And he, I'm pretty damn sure, if I remember right, he donated, if not all of it, most of it to charity as well. So, if somebody does that, I have a little bit of respect for him. And I never always wanted to see us destroy the guy, but nothing really ever happened with him, so he was okay. If any of you are Lance Armstrong haters, or even Lance Armstrong fans, I am more of I was a Lance Armstrong supporter, obviously, you know. I mean, that's where these all came from. This is not a Lance Armstrong bracelet, however. This is a Livestrong bracelet. Completely different. Anyway, there is a documentary out there called The Armstrong Why. Pretty damn good. It's shows kind of the hows and why and all that kind of crap as to how that all went down, and it shows what kind of a person he was and is, and very interesting. He's a very interesting human being. Still, there are not very many people out there as far as athletes. There are certain athletes out there that are just driven. And a lot of people who do not know cycling have no idea that cycling is a doped sport. The sport is just doped. It's doping. It's what it is. Don't know if it's much better now. But it always has been. And if you were going to ride the Tour de France and be on that level, you were doping. You were doing or are or whatever doing something, whether it's transfusing your blood, EPO, human growth hormone, whatever it is. If you want to ride with those guys, you have to do that. So, a lot of people say, well, he's a cheater, he's on this. Yeah, they all were. Every fucking one of them were. And he was the one that ended up having enough people around him to where other people, paid other people, and did this and did that, to where even if he could have got caught, he didn't get caught. And so a lot of you don't understand that it's not, there are sports where you can get by without some sort of enhancement of, you know, like that. But cycling, not really one of them. It is a brutal, brutal sport on the body. And not only that, a lot of people don't understand that cycling is also, it's a team sport. It's not just a one man on a bike racing all the other guys. There are teams, and how one person does is a lot of how the team does too. So anyway, just kind of got off on a bunch of other crap, but I just meant to say, if you are in one of those two categories of knowing who Lance Armstrong is, or intrigued by that at all, the Armstrong Lie is a good one. You can look at it in red box. You can probably see it online too. So just thought I'd mention that, because I just saw it last night. This cigar continues to smoke nicely. Gonna be letting you go now. Yeah, I just fell off of there, but it's still burning okay. Definitely not a bad cigar. It's definitely, like I said, if you wanna, you know, grab one of these. I didn't even think I showed the brand or anything, did I? Because I wasn't really planning on doing a review on it, but this is kind of pretty much a review. I don't have all the particulars as far as the tobacco and all, but that is it. That is the punch. So, the Gran Puro, and I don't remember what I said that the actual cigar is, but anyway, it'll be on the title. So that's really all I got. A whole bunch of talk. Bunch of blabbering, smoking a cigar, hanging out with you. Drinking this shitty coffee. See this bottle? I will predict that this will not be around long. Again, I could be wrong, real wrong, but I don't think I am. There's too many other good coffee drinks out there. Not to mention just going to a Starbucks or going to a Pete's Coffee or a Coffee Bean or a Coffee Leaf or a Tea Leaf or whatever the hell all those places are called. Anyway, cigar's good, coffee sucks. Have yourself a fantastic day, a good week. My weekends go way too fast, I can tell you that right now. But life is every day, so you gotta live it. Enjoy your day, enjoy your life. Keep your eyes open, keep learning stuff. Don't get all your information from the news. If there's one thing that you want to remember from this entire little long-ass video, is don't get your information from the news. Do not do that. Find your shit out. Read about it. Scour the internet. And I'm not saying the internet's the end-all be-all, but you can find the truth in there, and you can find the actual facts. So do that. And don't just go by what the news. You can start at the news and then work your way around. Okay? Alrighty. Well, looks like my plane's here. I gotta go.